Whoever would have thought that a corrupt prosecutor
would have a history of corrupt prosecution?
Viva Fry, Montreal litigator turned YouTuber, and this is Winnie the Westie. This is sort of a continuation of the McCloskey prosecution because it sort of is the prequel of sorts to Kim Gardner's corruption. For those of you who may not know, St. Louis Circuit Attorney Kim Gardner is now facing an ethics complaint, probable cause that she violated certain rules of prosecutorial conduct that could result in her getting disbarred. Now, the media has been covering this, but the media, I dare say, doesn't have the slightest understanding of what is going on. I had to dive into it, and I must admit, it is sufficiently complicated that I cannot blame the media for not understanding what is going on. The media is just running with generalized headlines, I suspect also because they kind of want to sweep this under the rug, but having dived into it with a little bit of detail, it is a fascinating situation, but let's just start with one article and the paradigm, quintessential, perfect example of
confession through projection.
Fox Files. Documents detail misconduct allegations against St. Louis Circuit Attorney Kim Gardner. Among the allegations, Gardner's concealment and misrepresentations during her 2018 investigation into former Missouri Governor Eric Greitens. The filing list, quote, more than 50 rule violations, end quote, including alleged, quote, false statements and failure to disclose evidence, end quote, on multiple occasions in March and April of 2018. The allegations say Gardner also misrepresented and concealed facts from her own colleagues. In response to the court action, her counsel wrote that Gardner had recently won re-election with, quote, an overwhelming majority, 74% of the voters. This information is another attempt by Ms. Gardner's political enemies, largely from outside St. Louis, to remove Ms. Gardner and thwart the systemic reforms she champions, end quote. According to Kim Gardner's attorneys, this is an attempt by her political enemies to remove her. Wait until you hear the basis of the complaint, because this is exactly what she was trying to do to Eric Greitens. But before we even get into the history, the context, the ethics complaint itself, a little context on Kim Gardner going back to the McCloskey situation. My father always tells me that success leaves clues. Well, so does corruption. Kim Gardner is the circuit attorney who was involved in the prosecution, arguably the corrupt prosecution of the McCloskeys. For those of you who may not know, the McCloskeys are that attorney couple who were indicted on charges of brandishing firearms because they stood outside their multi-million dollar mansion with firearms in order to stave off a group of protesters who busted down a private gate looking for the mayor's house. Not only were they actually indicted for ostensibly reasonably exercising their Second Amendment rights and self-defense, they were charged with tampering with evidence because the pistol that Ms. McCloskey pointed at the crowd apparently was not functional when it was seized by the investigators, and the investigators were told to disassemble and reassemble the weapon so that it could be totally functional, so they could be charged with the crime of brandishing firearms, because for those of you who don't know, that charge requires the firearm to be readily capable of lethal use. So the investigator under Kim Gardner's prosecution actually disassembled the gun, reassembled it so that it could be fully functional, so they could specifically charge Ms. McCloskey with that specific charge. And in the ultimate twist of Kafka-esque irony, after having tampered with the evidence, what happens? They charge the McCloskeys with tampering with evidence. So that is the Kim Gardner that we're talking about, but now let's get into this specific situation, and the charges against Kim Gardner stem back to 2018 and Eric Greitens. Eric Robert Greitens, born April 10, 1974, is an American politician, author, and former Navy SEAL who was the 56th governor of Missouri from January 2017 until his resignation in June 2018. He was the first Jewish governor of Missouri. Now go back to Kim Gardner's claim that the accusations against her are from political enemies who want to remove her and thwart her efforts. Let's go back and look over some of Eric Greitens' efforts that might have warranted people wanting to interfere and have him removed from office. First year, Greitens took office as governor on January 9, 2017. His first two executive orders banned employees in the executive branch from accepting gifts from lobbyists and froze all new regulations through February 2017. He remained opposed to accepting a federal Medicaid expansion in Missouri. In November 2018, a statewide referendum put heavy restrictions on lobbyist gifts, virtually banning them. On February 6, 2017, Greitens signed a bill making Missouri the 28th right-to-work state. In response, unions that opposed the law filed a referendum to overturn it, and on August 7, 2018, Missouri voters voted to overturn the right-to-work law. So Greitens had his own political agenda. He was trying to put through programs which some people didn't agree with, and what ended up happening? Well, he found himself embroiled in an extramarital affair that ultimately led to charges of blackmail, among other things. Charges brought against him by none other than Kim Gardner herself. Now, all of the charges against Greitens were ultimately dismissed, and this complaint against Kim Gardner relates to the fact that she apparently refused or failed to disclose otherwise exculpatory evidence in the context of that investigation, that she allowed her investigator to lie under oath and provide false information. Who would have thought that a corrupt prosecutor would have a history of corrupt prosecution? Special prosecutor appointment to investigate St. Louis Circuit Attorney. Following the dismissal of all charges against Greitens, his defense attorneys filed a police report with the St. Louis Metropolitan Police Department alleging criminal misconduct by Gardner's office in his case. On June 29, 2018, St. Louis Circuit Judge Michael Mullen appointed Gerard Comedy as special prosecutor to investigate the alleged misconduct by Gardner's office. On June 17, 2019, a 7-count felony indictment of William Tisby was unsealed. Tisby had been charged with 6 counts of felony perjury and 1 count of felony tampering with evidence. Tisby was the investigator that Kim Gardner hired, and lo and behold, yet again, accusations of tampering with evidence and
felony perjury.
Now, some of you might be saying, that's all fine and well for Tisby, but what does that have to do with Kim Gardner? Well, apparently Kim Gardner knowingly allowed Tisby to provide felony perjurious testimony in the context of this investigation. Apparently, Kim Gardner actively participated in all of the allegedly felonious conduct. Kim Gardner herself might have been spearheading it. The person who is saying that the charges against her are mere accusations from her political enemies trying to remove her to thwart the progress she wants to make, she is guilty of having done the exact same thing against Eric Greitens. Now, the complaint itself is 73 pages long, and we don't really need to go over all of it because it is just detail of the same type of behavior. We will go over the highlights of the ethics complaint, but bottom line, Kim Gardner is accused of having failed or refused to disclose otherwise exculpatory evidence, effectively telling or allowing her investigator to lie under oath and allowing him to produce false information under oath. And for anyone who may have had any lingering doubts, this is objectively unethical conduct. In the Supreme Court of the state of Missouri, en banc, in re, Kimberly M. Gardner, respondent. Information. Comes now the chief disciplinary counsel pursuant to Missouri Supreme Court Rule 5 and states and alleges as follows. Introduction. Informant is the chief disciplinary counsel appointed by this court pursuant to Rule 5.06. Informant has determined pursuant to Rule 5.11 that probable cause exists to believe that respondent is guilty of professional misconduct. Respondent is a duly licensed attorney admitted to practice in and before all courts of the state and is a member of the bar of the state of Missouri. Respondent's Missouri bar number is 56780 and she has been licensed to practice law in Missouri since September 29, 2004. Slight parentheses here, the OCD part of my personality derives irrational pleasure from the fact that her bar number is 4 consecutive numbers, 5, 6, 7, 8, followed by a 0. But now back to the important stuff of the complaint. Factual allegations. On January 11, 2018, respondent announced a formal criminal investigation into the alleged actions of now former Missouri Governor Eric Greitens that occurred nearly 3 years earlier. The allegations concerned Greitens' extramarital conduct with KS. Respondent used a private investigator, William Don Tisby of Intera LLC, in lieu of the Metropolitan St. Louis City Police Department or any other public agency. On January 17 and 18, 2018, respondent met with Tisby in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, to discuss the Greitens investigation. Tisby spent hours reviewing background materials respondent provided. So bottom line, Kim Gardner met and mandated this private investigator to conduct an investigation into Eric Greitens, and for those of you who don't know, in the context of criminal complaints, there is a positive obligation to disclose all evidence that might be exculpatory to the accused. And it would seem that for whatever the reason, Kim Gardner did not so disclose that potentially exculpatory information. On March 16, 2018, the state produced a privilege log. However, the following documents were neither listed in the privilege log nor produced to the defense. A. Gardner's 1/28/18 bullet points. B. Gardner's 1/28/18 email to Tisby. C. Tisby's annotated version of Gardner's 1/28/18 bullet points. D. Tisby's 1/30/18 handwritten notes of JW. E. Tisby's 3/13/18 email to Gardner. F. Tisby's draft interview narrative confidential of KS. And G. Tisby's draft JW interview. Now, for brevity, or actually just for practicality, because we do not need to and cannot get into the investigation itself, bottom line, Kim Gardner failed to produce documents that she was legally compelled to produce. She failed or refused to produce documents to the defense for the benefit of the defense that she was legally required to produce to the defense. And it goes even further because in the context of that file, she allowed her investigator to knowingly provide false information to the court. Apparently, Tisby, who was subsequently charged with felony perjury, provided false answers to the court. Kim Gardner knew those answers were false, and she nonetheless allowed him to produce those false answers to the court. And for those of you who don't know, that is unethical for a lawyer to do. Respondent knew the above answers were false because on January 17 and 18, 2018, respondent was in Baton Rouge, Louisiana with Tisby, who spent hours reviewing background materials respondent provided. In addition, respondent emailed Tisby, quote, Gardner's 12818 bullet points, end quote, prior to his interview of KS. Tisby falsely testified he did not ask KS any substantive questions during his interview of KS. And it goes on and on and on for 73 pages of the complaint. We don't need to get into the minutia of the details, just the highlights where Kim Gardner knowingly allowed her investigator to provide false information to the court. Respondent knew the above answers were false because she was with Tisby watching him make handwritten notes atop a double-spaced copy of, quote, Gardner's 12818 bullet points, end quote, during the interview. Tisby falsely testified he did not communicate with respondent during the lunch break of his deposition. Respondent, who was present at the court hearing, A, failed to correct Dierker's false and inaccurate statement, which she knew was false, by disclosing to the court that she, not Tisby, was the author of, quote, Gardner's 12818 bullet points, end quote, atop which Tisby made handwritten notes. Failed to correct Dierker's false and inaccurate statement, which she knew was false, by disclosing to the court that the original, quote, Gardner's 12818 bullet points, end quote, and particularly the last 45 bullet points of, quote, Gardner's 12818 bullet points, end quote, had not been produced to the defense. And C, failed to correct Dierker's false and inaccurate statement, which she knew was false, by disclosing to the court that, quote, Tisby's draft interview narrative confidential of KS, end quote, had not been produced to the defense. Just to open another parenthesis, some of you out there who might be extremely observant will notice the backdrop has changed. I had to move the car because they were doing some work on the train tracks that was making a little too much noise. Now, something that most people don't really fully know or appreciate, a lawyer cannot prevent someone from lying on the stand, but a lawyer cannot facilitate a witness lying on the stand. It is unethical for a lawyer to knowingly allow or abet a witness to provide false testimony to the court, and by the sound of this complaint, that is exactly what Kim Gardner did, either actively or passively. Respondent violated Rule 4-3.3A1, 4-3.4A and C, Rule 4-4.1A and B, Rule 4-5.1C1, and Rule 4-8.4A and C, when she provided false information to Dierker, who then falsely stated to Judge Burleson on March 19, 2018, that no notes regarding witnesses existed, no other notes, when respondent knew of the existence of A, Gardner's 12818 bullet points. And the list goes on. Respondent violated Rule 4-3.3A3, 4-3.3B, and 4-8.4C regarding Tisby's deposition on March 19, 2018 by failing to take reasonable remedial measures when she knew Tisby was giving false answers to questions regarding the following topics as fully described in paragraph 54 herein. And you can read the list on your own. Respondent violated Rule 4-3.3A and B, 4-5.3C, and 4-8.4C when she offered and elicited false testimony when questioning Tisby during his deposition on March 19, 2018 regarding the following topics as fully described in paragraph 56 above. And you can read it. A lawyer cannot knowingly offer or elicit false testimony from a witness, and if they do so, they are committing an ethical breach. And on the ethical violation of failure to disclose, the complaint states as follows. Respondent violated Rule 4-3.8D and 4-8.4C when she failed to disclose to the defense the following information known to her that tended to negate the guilt of the defendant or mitigate the offense. And you can read the list. That is the overview of the ethics complaint. It's 73 pages and we could go into more detail, but it is just more of the same. The bottom line, Kim Gardner is guilty exactly of that which she is accusing other people of.
What?
It would appear that the appearance of misconduct in the McCloskey case was actually just more of the same when it comes to Kim Gardner's conduct. This looks very bad. The complaint is very well detailed and fleshed out, and I smell big problems for Kim Gardner, and I smell an exoneration for the McCloskeys, but we will see where this goes. With that said, if you like my videos, you like my content, please be sure to like, share, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and drop a comment in the comment section below because it feeds the algorithm.
Tina, you fat lard, come get some dinner.
If you want to support my channel, you thought you could get away from me. If you want to support the channel, all of these support links are in the pinned comment. We've got PayPal, Patreon, subscribe to our YouTube membership. We've got merch. Robert Barnes and I do weekly live streams every Sunday. We do weekly streams with a guest every Wednesday called The Sidebar. We are also on Locals. It is otherwise known as
VivaBarnesLaw.locals.com.
All of my content is also on Rumble if you want to follow me there. But more important than anything, take care of yourselves, check in on friends and family, make sure everyone around you is doing well, and now you know your vlog. Peace out. Booyah.